We all know that duplicating code is a bad thing, but how do we avoid repeating ourselves? Well, this is where generics comes in. I'm Alex from Rebeloper.com, and today I'm going to talk about generics. So if you do like these kind of topics, go ahead and hit that subscribe button. Let's open up Xcode and let's dive in. One of the rule of thumbs of coding is not to repeat yourself. And the best way to do that is to learn how generics work. So today I'm going to dive deep into how you can create your own generics in your projects. Before we dive deep into the code, let me just remind you about Refactory, a 60-minute one-on-one Zoom call with yours truly. If you have any questions about Swift UI, Swift, let me know. It is at rebeloper.com/mentoring. This video is sponsored by WebView Gold. With WebView Gold, you can convert your web app or website into apps for iOS and Android. If you have a website or you'd like to have an app on the website or on the App Store, then you can do that with WebView Gold. With WebView Gold, all you have to do is provide a URL and you're done. But there's more. You can add push notifications, in-app purchases, ads, and much, much more. Check them out in the link in the description. Save 25% off with their back-to-school sale. Now, let's get back to the video. Let's dive deep into our today's topic, and that is generics and why you should use them. So I have prepared here a vanilla project. So it's just called generics, and that's just it. What you need to do is check out the link in the description for the resources. And once you download the resources from there, you will find all of these files. So as you can see, we already have a content view. So let's just delete this. Move to trash. And then just copy and paste all of these files. Okay, so let me just go through it briefly. What we are going to do is create kind of an API for a URL request. So we are going to have this person URL and post URL. Then we have our person struct model and our post model. Finally, we have our content view, and that is linked to our content view model. We have a published variable for person and a post, and then we have fetch person, an async froze function, and a fetch post. Finally, what you have to know here is that here is our view model linked to the content view, and we are having person post, two texts, and two buttons for fetching the person and the post. Finally, the actions for those two buttons in an asynchronous way. If you don't know how asynchronous fetching or asynchronous programming works with Swift UI 3, well, basically not Swift UI 3, with Swift 5.5, then go ahead and check out the video on async await on my channel. So basically that's our starter. Let's just create our endpoints here so we may fetch this. This will be really, really simple and fast. So what we want to do, let's just take a look at our models first. So here's our person, it has a name, and here is our post, it has a title. So let's just create this, and I'm just going to use object gen. I don't know how it's object gen or object gen, whatever. Take a look at this is our their site, and we just want to go name equals Alex, and as you can see, the JSON file has been created for you. So you want to copy this out and then go to mocky.io, and let's create a new mock right over here. Now mocky.io is really, really nice because it will store that database, kind of this mock database, on your browser and you can access it. It's really, really fun to do so. So here we have, that's just our response. Let's generate my API HTTP response. And now let's do the same for the title. And let's have this, generics are cool. Okay, let's copy that out and let's create another mock here really fast and add the body, generate HTTP response. And now we can take a look at these mocks. And as you can see, here is a link to that. So let's just go for the person first. And this is what we are going to get back. So let me just copy that out and go back to our Xcode project and add it right over here for the person URL. And then let's create Let's do the same for our post. Okay, copy that out and then go back to Xcode and paste it in there. So now we are already set up. We have our API for the person URL. So what are we going to do? Well, in the content view model, as you can see, we are having here a fetch person and a fetch post. So how would we do that? Let's just do it one step at a time, and then I will introduce generics and why you should use them. So first of all, let's grab our URL. So let URL string. That's API and then person URL. So that's our URL. We want to create an actual URL from this URL string. So we want to guard against that. So guard let URL equals, and let's initialize this URL with a string, and that's our URL string. Else, we want to create an error and throw it, because this is an async throws function. So let error ns error, and the main, well, let's just go no URL code 0 and user info. I don't care about the user info, that's nil. And then we want to throw this error. Okay. So now we got our URL. Let's just see what's going on here. Let's hit command B. So that error should go away, and it does. So now that we got our URL, let's use our new API for our URL session. And this will be really, really fun. Maybe you have heard of this. So what we are going to get back is a tuple, and the first element in the tuple is going to be the data, and then the response. I don't care about the response at this point. We want to try await and URL URL session, sorry, URL session dot shared, and from data, and you want to go from the one that is data from, and as you can see, it requires a URL, and there we go, URL goes right over there, and delegate, we don't care about the delegate at this point. Okay, so now that we have tried to get the data, and of course the response, which we are not going to use, from that URL, we want to try to decode it. So let's just create our, I will just simply add that to the published variable. So person equals, let's just try to JSON decoder, decode. There we go, decode, and that will be a person.self, and the data would be our data. Okay, and basically that should work. Let's just build and run and see if we do get back that person. Okay, let's just see. There we go, it's launching. Let me just resize this so we may better see it. Okay, so if I tap on fetch person, there we go, an Alex person will be fetched. Now, if you want to fetch the post, you would do kind of the same. So let's just do the thing that is not really recommended, and that is copying out this whole chunk of code and pasting it in there, and then just changing a few things, and that is our post URL and no URL. And finally, we want to put it into the post and decode it as a post model. Okay, and yeah, that should work. Let's just test it out. Let's just fetch the person. There we go, fetch the post. Generics are cool. Okay, so that's really great. And it is just a few lines of code, but you know, a rule of thumb is not to repeat yourself, and that's why we are going to create a generic for fetch. And how do we do that? With the help of generics. Now, the key point here is that you want to fetch a person and you also want to fetch a post with the same function. So let me just create this new private function. So private, because I'm going to use this in the fetch post and fetch person functions. So private func and simply fetch. And let's just add in there our URL string of type string. There we go. And this is async and froze. Okay, so basically that's kind of the basic function. Now let's add generics to it. Now what we want to do here is actually return either a person or a post. But how do we do that? Well, we want to know, we want to set a generic, and we are doing it right over here before the property declaration in the function name. And usually it's a capital C, and this is just how it's used to be doing it. And then we can just use that T that we declared right over here as the return type. Let's hit command B and let's see if we do have any errors. And as you can see, missing return in a function expected to return T. Well, we are going to return T, but before we do that, let me just show you that we can also make sure that the T is also of a certain type. And because JSON decoder requires its models to be codable, or basically decodable, but maybe you want to have it also encodable, then the T must be codable. And you could do anything here. Like you could just add in here any type of property that you want, protocol that you want right over here. Okay, so that's our setup. So T could be anything that is codable. So then let's just write out our function the new way. Well, first of all, you want to guard against the URL creation. So that I'm just copying that out. So now we do have a valid URL at this point. Now we want to get that data. Again, it's the same thing. And here comes the magic part, and I will just type this out right over here. Now that we got our data, we just go and return the JSON decoder's decode value. And of course, we want to try, because JSON decoder might fail. So JSON decoder dot decode, and now the decodable protocol will be t.self, and from that data. And basically that's it. Let's just wait for this. Let's hit command B and let's see if everything is okay. And it looks like everything, all the errors went away. So now we can use this fetch right over here. So let me just delete this. We don't need this at all. What we do want to add in here is just grab the post, the published variable, and that equals to fetch our API dot post URL. And of course, we want to try await. Okay, finally, we can do that for our person. So person equals try, because it's a throwing function, await, because it's an asynchronous function, and then fetch and API dot person URL. And as you can see, it automatically infers, sorry, I have to add in here person, it automatically infers what type of fetch the generic should have. Because we are assigning it to the person, which is of type person. Now, if we would have done this like let person equals and then try await. And let's see what happens here. Let's hit Command B. And as you can see, generic parameter T could not be inferred because we don't know what person is. Well, person is of type person. And now, if we hit Command B, now we will know. And we can just assign this person to the published variable. But that's kind of two lines. And why not use automatic inferring of the type value there? So basically, that's it for generics. It's really, really simple to understand, and rarely we use that, but here we go. You have a really hands-on example how you should remove code duplication with the help of generics. Now, if you do like these types of tutorials, go ahead and check out rebeloper.com/mentoring, where you can have a 60-minute Zoom call with me, where I can explain all of these cool advanced Swift stuff, or I can teach you Swift UI, or if you have a bug in your code, let me know. I can also help you with that. So it's at rebeloper.com/mentoring. Knowing generics is a superpower, so go ahead and try them out. Use them in your own projects. And if you do like this video, go ahead and give it a thumbs up. It helps with the YouTube algorithm. And while you're at it, make sure to hit that notification bell to get notified of these videos. Go ahead and check them out right now. They are all about Swift UI, Swift in general. And as usual, I will see you in the next one.